Good morning, my dear students. Today topic is circular motion. What is mean by circular motion? A body is said to be in circular motion that moves along a circular path. That body moves along a circular path. That is circular motion. Next is uniform circular motion. A body moves along a circular path with constant speed. Speed is constant. That is known as uniform circular motion. In this case, uniform circular motion, velocity changes continuously. That means it is accelerated motion. That is, it is accelerated. Velocity, that means the direction changes continuously. Then, next is, in this case, we are discussing the two topics. First is centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration. Next is centripetal force. What is centripetal acceleration? Centripetal acceleration means the acceleration in case of circular motion. In case of circular motion, accelerated, that acceleration acting towards the center. Acceleration acting towards the center is known as centripetal acceleration. Centripetal force means force producing centripetal acceleration. Force producing centripetal acceleration is known as centripetal force. We know that the situation FC. FC means centripetal force. Centripetal force FC is equal to mv square divided by r. R means that's the radius, v means velocity, m means mass. Mv square divided by r. This is centripetal force, that's the equation. In our syllabus, two topic is given. First one is motion of a car along a circular level road. Second one is banked road. Two cases are there. First case, car moves along a circular road. We know that we have to consider that. Car moves on a circular road. Circular road. That means, we are considering that two cases. First one is vertical. Second one is horizontal. In case of vertical means like this it is, vertical. Vertical, car moves on a circular road. Two cases are there. First one is vertical, second one is horizontal. Vertical, there is no acceleration. Then we know that in case car moves on a circular level road, okay, acceleration towards the center of the circle. Okay, acceleration towards the center. Then this says this is vertical, this one is horizontal. Here is car position, here only. Then weight acting downwards. Weight is acting downwards. Then that is normal reaction. Reaction is acting upwards. Then we can write, in case of vertical motion, first equation we can write n minus mg is equal to 0. N minus mg is equal to 0. Mg means that's the weight. Weight acting downwards. N means that's a normal reaction, that's the reaction acting upwards. N minus mg is equal to 0. From this case, n is equal to mg. This is our first equation. N is equal to, second case, in case of first is vertical, second is horizontal. In case of horizontal, that means two forces is acting. Two forces means one is frictional force. Frictional force, which friction? That means friction is acting between this car and the road. That means tire and the road. Frictional force is created between tire and the road. That is frictional force. Frictional force, we know that. That is friction is static friction. That is less than or is equal to mu s n. That's our equation. Static friction equation F is equal to or less than or is equal to mu s n. Mu s means coefficient of static friction. Mu s means coefficient of static friction. N we know that. Then F less than or is equal to mu s n. That is equal to two forces. One is frictional force. Second case is centripetal force. Centripetal force, which one? We are already discussed. That is equal to mv square divided by r. Mv square divided by r. From this equation, our aim is to calculate this velocity speed we are to calculate. From this equation, we can calculate this. V square is equal to, otherwise v square we can write mu s n r divided by m. Mu as n r divided by m. Then here we know that r is equal to, then n is equal to mg. We can substitute here n is equal to mg. Then mu s mg r divided by m. M cancel. Then we get our final equation, that is v max, or v max is equal to root of mu s g r. In a curved level rod, skidding of vehicle in a curved level rod, the outer edge should be raised above the inner edge. That's what, outer edge of the rod should be raised above the inner edge. That is known as banking of rods. Here I have written here how moving on a banked circular rod. Car moves on a curved circular rod, banked circular rod. Here I have drawn this diagram. This is same case only. First case, which one? That is vertical. Second case, that is horizontal. I have drawn separately this diagram. First case, that is vertical. Second case, that is horizontal. First case, there is no acceleration. Then we know that here is theta. This car moves on a banked circular rod. This is car. Then this is, that is theta resolved into two components. That is cos theta and sine theta. Then in this case, normal reaction, that is m cos theta, here is, that is frictional force, F sin theta. Then we can write, first case, m cos theta. This is acting upwards. This is balancing this force. Then we can write mg plus F sin theta. F sin theta. This is our first equation in case of vertical motion. The next case, it is horizontal motion. Horizontal means that is like this. It is horizontal. Here is which acceleration is producing? That is centripetal acceleration is producing. Then we can write, here is F cos theta, second case. F cos theta plus N sin theta. Sin theta is equal to M V square divided by R. This is second case. Then we know that what is frictional force? Frictional force F is equal to mu s n. Mu means coefficient of static friction. Then F we can substitute, F equal to mu s n. Then from equation 1 we can write n cos theta is equal to mg. F means mu s n sin theta. Mu s n sin theta. Second case, we can write F means, that is mu s n cos theta plus n sin theta is equal to m v square divided by r. This is equation. First equation is third. Next one is fourth. Then equation 3, we can calculate this n. N, what do you have to write? We can take this n cos theta, this ns, the n sin theta, this term we can take this side. That is, it will come minus mu s n sin theta is equal to mg. Then we can take outside, n is equal to, otherwise we can take outside, n cos theta minus mu s sin theta is equal to mg. Then from this equation we can calculate this n is equal to, what do you have to write? mg divided by cos theta minus mu s sin theta. n is equal to mg divided by cos theta minus mu s sin. We have to take n outside. N into sin theta plus mu s cos theta is equal to mv square by r. Then we already got n, value of n. N we have to substitute here. That is mg by cos theta minus mu s sin theta. Then sin theta plus mu s cos theta is equal to mv square divided by r. Then m cancel. Both side m is cancel. then we can write that is our aim is to calculate this v square. V square we can calculate. V square is equal to rg. R we can take this side. Rg into sine theta plus mu s cos theta divided by cos theta minus mu s sine theta. Then here we have to divide it by cos theta. This side we have to divide it by cos theta. Then we get that is equal to rg into sine by cos that is tan theta. Sine by cos that is tan theta plus cos by cos that is equal to what? Then mu s. Mu s divided by cos theta by cos theta that is 1 minus mu s sin theta by cos theta that is tan theta. Our equation v max is equal to rg into tan theta plus mu s divided by 1 minus mu s tan theta. This is v max square. Then v is equal to this one root of otherwise we can use 1 by 2 root of rg into tan theta plus mu s divided by 1 minus mu s tan theta. Thank you. Tomorrow we will discuss on the topic another lesson, that is work and energy.